Okay, hello, welcome to the session about the Joomla bug squad. Let's start with a little bit about me. My name is Niels Braczek. You'll find me on the net with my username Nibra, or on Twitter as a hippie, because that's what I am. I'm working as a software quality consultant. It's in essence making development teams much more effective. And I'm developing since ages. I've worked on mainframes, Amigas, PCs, embedded systems, whatever you can think of. It's hardware, I've programmed it. Not bicycles yet, but maybe that starts. I'm doing PHP since last century. Started with Mambo when it's with Joomla when it started. It still was Mambo. And I'm a clean code evangelist. That means that I'm very eager to have clean code because it's better maintainable and just makes more fun to work with it. So what is the bug squad? The bug squad, of course, has a history. And when it was founded, its name was Quality and Testing Working Group. It was short after Joomla came into life. I'm not sure if it was 2005 or 6 when it was founded. but it was created very early, and its duty was to test and evaluate major and minor releases, make sure that it's secure, stable, and performant. And we should organize, process, and test all the reports, all the tracker, all the forums, and all that stuff. And of course, improve the code between the major releases. When 1.0 were ready and we started on 1.5, the development team transferred the responsibility for the release to the quality and testing team. And that marked the switch from the feature-oriented view to the more, let's say, security and stability focused way. But because it took so long time between 1.0.12 to 1.5, and there was a switch in leadership and so on, it led to that we left a lot of our members. So there was not many people left. So the team wasn't really able to do their job. It was too much work for too few people. So in September 2007, the group was disbanded. So of course this was a problem because we had nobody to take care of all the bugs and things we had. So to fill the gap, the first Pizza Bug and Fun event was organized. It was a very big thing. Joomla from New York, San Francisco, Washington, Vancouver, and Brussels worked together at the same time. And they fixed about 88 things, 100, or however you want to count it. But they were very effective, and that's why we're still doing PBF events today, because it just works. But during that event, there was an idea that we need something like this quality and testing working group. We need it. So the idea came to make a new team and to organize it differently. And this team was called the Bug Squad. So of course, they should handling the feedback process and all this stuff, keep the tracker up to date, perform testing, guide people in forums and during PDF events, provide patches, and and they did. So in 2010, the Bug Squad has built up until May 2010, they had built some sub-teams For example, a tracker team that has a duty to track, to look at the tracker. The coding team that wrote the patches, the testing team that tested all that stuff, an automated testing team that was intended to write unit tests so we can test automatically, and a migration and upgrade team, which should support the migration and make it as smooth as possible. Okay, fine, so good, it worked, and but some of those groups never get that active that we wanted. So there was a lot of change then after that. We got the volunteers portal, and that led to a lot of those groups bubbling up in the hierarchy and coming up to the same level as the Bugsport was. For example, there was founded a system testing working group and a unit testing working group. Separately. And then people encountered that it was not a good idea, and it was fusioned to the automated testing team. But other than the automated testing was a sub team of Bugsport. So how should we squash bugs if we don't have control of automated testing? It's a problem. Huh? And that's not the only thing, there happened more. We have specific release teams. Therefore, for each release, we have a new team being responsible for the release. So that's not our duty any longer. So we don't have control over the bugs that go out in the first release. No? So there was not much left what we could do. And now we have a new organizational structure. Was a transition, and we had to redefine our purpose. And Michael, as department leader, asked all team leaders to write a paper stating the purpose, the function, and the roles of each working group. And that actually was a very good idea, so I had to make my mind up and say, so what is Box Squad about? What's our duty? What are we for? So, this is, it's exactly what's our job. We have to reduce the number of bugs in Joomla. So, not only the CMS, we have a lot of Joomla projects. And I think that the Bug Squad has to do it for all Joomla projects. The framework, and the Joe Robo thing we have, and all the automation testing, we have a lot out. We have hundreds of repos. And we have to watch all of them. That's the main sentence. Yeah? Reduce the bugs. So, how do we do that? The first, of course, is we have to scan all of the resources. Yeah? There are forums, mailing lists, social media, Stack Overflow, and all that stuff. And we have to look into it if there is something that smells like an issue. So, and then, if we think it could be an issue, we should assist the original poster to put it on the tracker. Because it does not help the community if we do that. We have to educate the community to do that on their own. And that's a very important point, what's the change in Bug Squad. We are no longer trying to do everything ourselves. Yeah? We are trying to teach. So, if this person is not people to do that, okay, then we do that. Yeah? So we are backup for it. And of course, it's our duty then to leave a reference on the original channel so people see it's addressed. So the second thing is to confirm bugs. Because when people tell, okay, I found a bug, most often the bug is sitting in front of the computer. So not everything that's reported actually is an issue. So someone has to decide, is it an issue or not. So how can you do that? in a way that you can explain to others. There's only one way. Yeah? You have to write a test that can recreate the issue. A test that should be green, but isn't. If you can do that, then it's a bug, and only then. Unfortunately, we don't have the infrastructure for that. We can't do that. We can to some extent, but not as good as I wanted. Because we don't have the test frameworks ready yet. We did some in Google Summer of Code project last year, but it's not fully merged into the core yet, so we can't use it. Yeah? But it's work in progress, it's getting better. So at one day, I hope we have the ability to just confirm the bug by writing a test. Doesn't have to be unit test, but it's so-called acceptance tests. There's a special language for it, it's called Gherkin. Don't be afraid, it's plain English. You just say, as an editor, given I am in the article manager, when I click on that button, then I expect this to happen. You just write a test in that way. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And the framework behind it translates it into code and can execute the test. So everybody can write tests then. That's the basic idea. So on the tracker item, directly, you write this kind of text and you have the test. And you can see it happens or not. Yeah? That's what we want to do. Yeah? So they don't exist yet, so we still have to continue with the old way.
That's great, I think.
Yeah, but it's a tremendous lot of work.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why automated testing team needs people who can do the same things like that. So, but until then, we have to do it manually and just decide, okay, it's a bug, the description is good enough, so we can reproduce it. So we accept that instead of the test and start fixing it. So, and of course, we have to make sure that type, severity and priority is set correctly. That's the duty of the members of the bug squad. So, and then, of course, fixing bugs. So, who should do that? I don't guess it's me. I'm writing tests. That's the people. For the media manager, it's a media manager team. They built that bug. They have to fix it. Mm-hmm. We assist them. We are writing tests as they can't. And if they are unable to do that, then we do it. Only then. Yeah? That's okay, that's not how it's now. That's how I want it to be. I just started a month ago or two, and it takes some time until I have all that in place. But that's where it goes. Yeah? Because it makes much more sense if people that are into the domain are fixing it with themselves. Because I know nothing about the media manager. I've heard about it, I've read about it, but I've never used it, I've not looked into the code. So if I should fix a bug in there, I need a couple of hours to understand all that, and then maybe I can fix it.
And it's worthless.
Yeah, and it does not make sense. So the media manager team should do that. And I can tell them how. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because it's a process. I know everything about this process. So I can tell them. So, and then, of course, follow up the issues. Yeah, this is a problem because this doesn't work in any way currently, but we're working on it. Because whenever an issue gets stuck, so we have old issues, for example, why aren't they handled? Why do we have them? Why it's not fixed? Yeah, somebody has to have an eye on it. And that's our duty, absolutely. We have to do that. And so we have to look, what's the reason? Why did this get stuck? Why it's not done? And then, of course, fix it. Yeah? Put it on track again and make people work. But it doesn't work now. But we are working on it to solve that. Then, of course, testing patches. Currently, we need two explorative tests to accept a patch. Explorative means there's a person sitting in front of a computer and try it. And if this person feels, okay, it looks good, it says, okay, it works for me, and if two people say that, it's merged. It's of course a problem, because nobody looks everywhere. So if you have two explorative tests, it actually says nothing. Yeah? You don't know if it really works. Because how many data did you test? Did you test it with 100,000 records? Yeah? Nobody did.
People?
Nobody does. Yeah? So that's a problem. So we need an automated system. And that's what the automated testing team is working on. I'm a member of it because of the conjunction to Bugspot. And we are working on making a Docker-based environment. So you just set up, I want to test this on Nginx and Apache. I want to test it on PHP 5.6, 7.0, 7.1. I want to test it with, if you make an extension, for example, with Joomla 2.5, 3.4, 3.5, 3.6, 3.7, 4.0 staging, and so on. Yeah? Or with Postgres or MySQL database or SQL Server. So you can just write a small XML file declaring the combination you want, and the system is just firing up for you the complete network in Docker and runs the tests automatically in these combinations. That's what we're currently working on in a Google Summer of Code project.
Sounds perfect.
Yeah? And we'll do that for core on one place, but also provide it for extension developers. So they can
test
their extensions on every thinkable environment.
That's great.
Yeah, I'm using this for my own development for years already, and I ported this virtualization thanks to Joomla to our world. So that's most of the part of the work, you could say, but it's not. The most important thing is, the stack metrics is defined by the product department, of course, for regarding the core. Yeah, which databases do we test with? Which do we support officially? Officially, currently it's only MySQL. We have dropped SQL Server and so on because we can't test it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it doesn't make sense to support that. Mm-hmm. We also dropped HVM because it always fails on Travis. Yeah, but it's mostly due to Travis, not because our code doesn't do it. Mm-hmm. But Travis has problems with it, so we can't properly test it, so we're not sure it works. So we got support for that. So, no, our main duty should be that.
Yes.
Yeah? The best part is the one never occurring. And we try only have those.
Is it possible?
No, absolutely not. But there's a trick to do that. It's to write the test first.
Culture.
Yeah? If you write the test in the beginning, you have clear expectations about what your method should do. You expect that if I put this into that, I want this to get up. So you write this test. If you run the test, of course it's red because you don't have any code yet. But as soon as you write the code, just to make the test green, it does the correct thing. Yeah? In that way, you don't write code you don't need. Yeah? And you'll get 100% test coverage. So you know it works, and you know that in the future, with the rest you develop, you don't destroy anything because you have a test for it. Yeah? That's why we need a test first culture. And I guess that's the hardest part of this project. Yeah? Because many people are afraid of tests. I don't know why. It's easy. But okay. Yeah? But it's finding bugs during development is the most effective way to zero bugs. Yeah? It's faster not to write them. <At all. laughs> So, now the problem is, okay, there's a lot of things to do. And how many people?
How many people you need?
Yeah, actually, in the member list, we have a very long list. Okay. I have to clean it up because 90% of them I've never seen on the tracker. Maybe they're active on the forums. I don't know. I don't have numbers on it. I can't measure it. Mm-hmm. Yes, but I can see everything on the tracker. And most of the current Duck Squad members are not active on the tracker at all. So they are not members of the Duck Squad.
Yes.
Yeah. What would we do? We ask people to do that. Yeah. We had good experience with the big event in 2007. And some user groups have done Pizza Bug and Fun events on their own, and they were very successful. And so what we are doing is with these events, with Joomla days all over the world, and with the user groups, to help them to organize those events. And if we get to know in time, I make sure that people are available on GLIP to support for the tracker. So I see the Bug Squad members, not the contributors. All of them taking part in such events are contributors, and they are very valuable. But from the members, I expect to be mentors. They should coach, should mentor people, teach. Yeah, that's what I expect as a TV from Bug Squad. And that's what's new. Yeah? Until now, we try to do anything ourselves, and it does not work. We are too few people. We have a job we need to do for our living, so we can't be here 24 hours a day and 24 hours a night. It's not possible. So we need many hands, and that's why we want to do these kind of events. My basic idea is to make a cycle around the world by time zones. So we get around the world once a year. Yeah, so every time zone is in there, and then we can be available on GLIP and help and do all the heavy lifting. Yeah, that's all what I intend to do with the Bug Squad. So we have some resources for you. We have a volunteers portal, of course. There you can see our reports as soon as we start publishing them. Yeah, it's hard to publish without numbers. So I can't report any success because I can't measure it currently. But that's something I'm working on, so don't be afraid, there will come something. We have the Bug Squad portal and the docs. We have the issue tracker, of course. And we have something called patch tester component. Have you ever heard of it? Yeah?
Yeah.
It's a very great thing. You install it as a component into your own Joomla. And then you can select pull requests from the tracker, install them temporarily, test, report, deinstall again, and take the next one. It's a very nice thing to have. Yeah? Especially for those explorative tests we need now, because we don't have others. It's very easy to get the code and install it and test it, because if you see the PR on the tracker, I guess most people don't know how to get to it and install it on their own computer. But with this patch tester, it's very easy. Everybody can do. And I encourage everybody to. So, of course, we are communicating on GLIP, because that's something it's a decision made project-wide. Joomla communication is on GLIP. Mm-hmm. So there are two channels, the public discussion for contributors. Everything is invited, everybody's invited to be there. Everybody has access. And the team channel is for the members. So we can discuss and organize our internal problems without making them too public. of course, in GitHub, I said we have hundreds of repos. We have three organizations on GitHub. It's Joomla, where, for example, the Joomla CMS lives. It's Joomla Projects, where, for example, Joomla X lives. And we have Joomla Extensions, where, for example, Weblinks live. Yeah? All of them, we should have an eye on. That's what we work with. So that's quite all about the history and the future of the Bug Squad. Do you have any questions? Everything clear? Want to join?
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, then I say thank you. And I want to invite you to Make It Happen session, where we do some bug squashing, because we have a long history of issues on the tracker, which are quite old. And during this Make It Happen session, to reduce it in that way, that the oldest issue is not older than 100 days. So it's a big task. Yeah? But a lot of them is just close because they are timed out. Yeah? But we have to clean up. And that's what I want to do in the Make It Happen session. Yeah? So just get through, take the oldest one. Can I do anything with it? Do I need help with it? Then ask. Yeah? And then we squash it. Should not be, it's in the age of an issue, should have maximum two numbers. That's a goal.
Is there an online and test environment available, or only local?
Now we have to use a patch tester and do it locally.
Yeah.
The Docker environment I talked about is in progress. It's not usable yet.
No, I understand that. Yeah. I thought maybe there is another online environment to test.
Or should we just install Joomla locally and the patch tester and just click it?
Yeah, that's the way we do it here. Yeah. We have to do it locally.
The usable way.
Yeah, because this automatic, I know someone is working on this actually, that we have an installation on the web, which we can use for testing.
Yeah, we used it during the Pizza Jackson Fun in the Netherlands.
Okay.
You were using it?
Yeah.
You were using it?
Yeah.
It's working.
Yeah.
Testing environment, but you're using
so
it already.
Yeah, so people don't have to set up locally a test environment.
Okay.
But
I need more information about that,
yeah.
Because I have to spread it.
And
yes.
How does it work? It's an online installation, you can just log in or something like this? How does it work?
Yeah.
It's a web application, yes?
Yeah, well, I think they just put it online when they only have a piece of bugs and fun.
Yeah.
And just put it offline when it's...
I know that someone in the automatic testing group actually is working on this.
Okay.
Yeah. So we have it permanently.
Yeah. Okay.
But as far as I know, it's not ready yet. Mm-hmm. So we do it the old way.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Fine. Okay.
Okay. So I thank you very much for your interest, and hope to have many people within the Make It Happen sessions. Thank you.
Thank you.